Nearly 20 years after her kidnapping, J.C. Dugard will finally see justice served against her captors.
Philip and Nancy Garrido are scheduled to be sentenced in just a couple of hours from now.
And KCRA3's Shari Kinishams is live at the El Dorado County Courthouse with more.
Adrian, good morning. Still a lot of questions about just exactly what we'll hear in the courtroom this morning. It'll really be interesting to hear the statements from the two defendants, Philip and Nancy Garrido, or from their lawyers on their behalf. It's remarkable to note, though, the vast difference between the image of Nancy Garrido, this image that we all have of her as kidnapper and accomplice to her husband, very different from the picture of her that her attorney tries to portray for the public. Just listen to this statement from him, which was made to KCRA3 just yesterday. He describes a meeting between his client, Nancy Garrido, and her victim, J.C. Dugard.
The last time she met with J.C., it was she wanted to hug her. And I believe the people that psychologists been working with J.C. said, no, you got to get rid of her. Or it was crushed her really quick. She wanted to hug her really badly. And didn't happen.
Attorney Steve Tapson, they're saying Nancy Garrido wanted to hug the girl that she and husband Philip Garrido kidnapped and held captive for 18 years. So today in court, expect Tapson to read a statement from Nancy Garrido. It's not clear if there will be a statement from Philip Garrido. The two pleaded guilty back in April in a deal that will just about ensure that they will spend the rest of their lives in prison. Philip Garrido is to be sentenced to 431 years to life in prison. His wife, Nancy, to be sentenced to 36 years to life in prison and will only be eligible for parole after 31 years. Now, back out here live this morning, the other big question is whether J.C. Dugard will be in court today. I can tell you while the answer is not clear yet this morning, there are media from all over the country, members of news agencies from across the country actually waiting to see if that will happen and hoping if it does happen to get a glimpse of her. I can tell you the proceedings get underway inside the courthouse at 9 o'clock this morning. And of course, as soon as those sentences are officially handed down by the judge, you can expect to hear it first here on KCRA3. Live here in El Dorado County this morning, I'm Shari Kinishams, KCRA3 reports.